Hello students, welcome to the session. Today I'm going to talk about one of the meridian, heart meridian. Heart meridian is one of the in meridian. So when we describe any meridian, we need to know about the general description. So general description here regarding the polarity. It is a possesses in polarity, or it is also known as a Zhang organ, and it connects to heart and it Liu connects with the small intestine. Each meridian will connect to one five element, that is fire. Here heart and small intestine together represents fire element, and the number of points heart meridian possesses is 9. It starts from the center, that is from the center of the axilla, and it ends at the fingertip. Hence the direction of energy flow here is centrifugal. Since it starts from the center and ends in the periphery, the direction is centrifugal. So coming to the important function of heart meridian, according to the TCM concept, heart controls the brain. In modern concept also, heart controls the circulation and also it regulates the brain through the blood supply. If a small moment blood flow from the heart to the brain stops, the brain functions also lost. So that is why in modern diagnosis and modern concept, as well as in TCM, heart is an important vital organ. And the excess or deficiency, the excess of heart, or that is excess of energy to the heart, which is resulting in excess of fire element, which can lead to the dysregulation in the mental functions. So that is why regulated function of heart is very essential to maintain the general body function as well as the function of brain. Coming to the pathway, so it starts from the heart and it divides into 3 branches. One is inner ascending, another one is inner descending, another one is superficial branch. So what about the path of these 3? So the inner ascending branch ascends upwards from the heart to the chest and also to the eye and brain, whereas inner descending branch descends from the heart to the small intestine to communicate with its Liu connecting meridian. Coming to the superficial branch, from the center of the axilla, it descends downwards along the medial aspect of the upper arm, medial aspect, anterior medial aspect of the forearm, anterior medial aspect of the wrist, and then ends at the lateral aspect of the little finger at the corner of the nail. This is about the pathway of heart meridian. Coming to the therapeutic benefits, so each meridian will have its own therapeutic benefits. Here when we consider the heart as such, the important diseases along the pathway of meridian, so we can consider the rheumatoid arthritis, any points on the hand, then on the wrist, painful conditions, local areas, elbow pain like golfer's elbow, and even in the shoulder pain, heart meridian can be, points from the heart meridian can be used, and also internally to treat the heart disorder as well as the disorders of the brain like depression, anxiety, sleeplessness, and also it will have a homeostatic and sedative effect. Points from the heart meridian will have sedative effects also. Now coming to, there are 5 important points which are considered as 5 element points. They are like heart, 9, then 8, 7, 4 and 3 respectively, wood, fire, earth, metal and water element point. According to 5 element concept, these points can be used to sedate or to stimulate the excess or deficiency of these five elements, corresponding five elements. Coming to the important points of the heart meridian, the heart one is considered as one important point by its location, because it is located at the center of the axilla, medial to the axillary artery. It is known as check one. It is considered a partially dangerous point because it is situated by the side of the axillary artery. So we need to palpate. If we happen to prick this point, we need to palpate the axillary artery and prick medial to that point, five chin straight, and the conditions mainly in case of any pain in the axilla. So next point, very important, is heart 3, that is Shavuot High, location at the medial end of the transverse elbow crease. It's a very important point which is used mainly to treat the painful conditions of the elbow. A needling technique is 0.3 to 0.5 chin straight. Depending on the individual tachy level, we can consider the depth of the needling. Direction is perpendicular direction. Next is heart 4. Again, this point is on the palm, which is located 1.5 chin proximal to the medial end of the wrist crease. So indication, as a local indication, any painful conditions of the forearm, or in case of rheumatoid arthritis, we can use these points. Needling technique is 0.5 to 1 chin straight. Next, coming to one important point, that is heart 5, Tongli, which is used for speech disorder, specifically for speech disorder, hoarseness of the voice, irritation in the voice, or any inconvenience in the vocal cord. These conditions, this heart 5 can be used. So location, we have to identify the medial end of the transverse wrist crease, and it will be taken 1 inch or 1 chin posterior to the medial end of the transverse wrist crease. Apart from this speech, it can be also used in palpations, dizziness, blurness of the vision, and sudden loss of voice, aphasia with stiffness of the tongue, and pain in the wrist and elbow. Next point is the sixth point. The heart 5 is also considered as a Leo connecting point of the meridian. Next, heart 6, Yingzi. This is one of the Z cleft point of the meridian. Z cleft refers to the point which is used during the acute emergencies. Location 0.5 chun above the medial end of the transverse wrist crease. So here, this point is used in any acute emergencies like night sweat, hysteric attacks, cardiac pain, or any angina, or even in epistaxis, sudden loss of voice. This point can be used effectively. Next, heart 7, one of the important potent tranquilizing point. It is known as Shenmen. It is a very important sedative point also. It can be used in insomnia. Location is very easy to locate. 0.5 chun proximal, just proximal to the posterior border of the pisiform bone or medial end of the transverse wrist crease. So in case of insomnia, depression, anxiety, we need to select this point with preference. Next is the last point of the meridian, heart 9, which is a Jingwell point, which is located 0.1 chun proximal to the lateral end of the nail bed of the little toe. So this is used in acute emergencies. Strangler needles are used at this point. So these are the common points which are used in heart meridian, and preferably in therapy we use heart 3, heart 5, and 6 and 7 are potent therapeutic benefits.